Hello guys and welcome to this new video. Before starting with the video, I would like to tell you about that I am also available on Academy platform. You can follow me on Academy search for my name Girish Kadam. You will get the profile over that. So you can follow me on Academy also, thereby making regarding net videos for your net also, get exam also. Okay. Also, I am available on Academy Plus platform. So my courses on organometallic chemistry and coordination chemistry plus courses already taken place. So you can enroll this. You can enroll in the plus course on Academy Plus course for upcoming courses. Okay. Also, by getting an Academy Plus subscription, you can use this code, that is Girish Kadam 999. So you will get the 10% monetary benefit from this. Okay. So this is about the Unacademy. You can follow me on Academy Plus and Unacademy also. Okay. Let's go with the topic of this video, that is previous year question. Okay. So we talk about till now four reagent, that is Grignard reagent, Gilman reagent, organotin reagent, organolithium reagent, LDA. So I have compiled some 4 to 5 questions of your previous year question. So this will be series of video where I will be discussing about reagent also, and separate videos on your previous year solved question from. Okay. So this question was asked in December 2011 for 4 mark. Okay. Now this question based on your Grignard reagent. So in presence of copper, if you see, there is a copper is given. In presence of copper, your Grignard reagent show 1,4 addition. Okay. So you have to choose which will the correct option, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now just by looking of this option, let's say okay, 1,4 addition, your Me minus going to attack on this. Okay, your Me minus going to attack on this. So what happen ultimately, this and this will be kicked out. So you have to concern about this C and D. Okay, so in presence of copper, your Grignard reagent going to attack on 1,4 addition. In absence of copper, generally it will give 1,2 addition. But in this case, what happen? It will specially give your 1,4 addition product. Now let's see the solution. How it going to happen? So first step is a 1,4 addition that we have note that if you followed my reagent chemistry video, that is a Grignard reaction where I mentioned that in presence of copper, your Grignard reagent is going to attack on 1,4 position, that is this position. Okay. Don't worry about the stereochemistry just to confuse you, nothing about that. So what happened? This enolate will be formed when this attack going to take place. Okay. So this double bond migration and this enolate will be formed. After formation of enolate, if you do the hydrolysis, you usually get this alcohol. Okay, after getting hydrolyzed, you will get alcohol. But there is a in second step, what happened? There is a allylic allyl halide is given. So what happened? This negative charge going to come in original position, and this double bond going to attack on this position. So what happened? This double bond going to migrate over here, and this chlorine will be leave. Okay, this chlorine will be leave. Due to what happened, this new carbon-carbon bond formation going to take place. Okay. Till now we seen about the Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis give your alcohol. Okay. But what if you do not do the hydrolysis, just react with this allylic alcohol. Okay. Allylic halide. So what happened? There is a attack on that particular carbon atom. This double bond going to attack on this species. Okay. So what happened? This double bond going to migrate and chlorine will be kicked out. So you will get this type of product where at alpha position, alpha alkylation going to possible by using Grignard reagent, just not doing the last step of hydrolysis. The correct answer will be this. Okay, what will the correct answer? Correct answer will be this. Okay, not this. I hope you got this mechanism. You can pause the video and check this mechanism also. So how it was going to take place. Okay, you can. First is a 1,4 addition. If you don't know the mechanism 1,4 addition, plus please go and check my Grignard reagent video. So in presence of copper, your Grignard reagent show 1,4 addition. So that 4 position going to attack by your Me minus, that is this. Okay, after attacking Me minus, there is a no hydrolysis process, so you are going to attack this with the allylic halide. Okay, now let's see the next example. So this is based on your LDA. And what is using? This is a beta keto ester. Okay, beta keto ester is given. So two equivalent of LDA going to react with LDA or react with beta keto ester. After that, there is another allylic bromide. You get A, and after that you have to react with lithium aluminum hydride, and after do hydrolysis. So what happens generally? Lithium aluminum hydride is a very strong reducing agent. It reduces aldehyde, ketone, ester. Okay, that type. So it is a very strong reducing agent. Now if we carefully see, this if you see B product, this has ketone and this has ketone. So you know that lithium aluminum hydride do not attack on all the reagent. Means what I'm saying that it have to reduce it, its selectivity is not there, it has very reactive nature. So lithium aluminum hydride going to react with ketone, it does not like that it's only react with ester and just keep the ketone, it going to reduce the ketone also. So this product means this option get cancelled and this option get cancelled just by knowing the function of lithium aluminum hydride. Okay, now if you see this reduce, this is reduced form, this is reduced form, this is reduced form, this is reduced form, but this form is reduced, this is not reduced. So you can use that way. If you don't know the mechanism earlier, you can knock down the two option B and D. Now we have check with this, we have to left with A and C. For that we have to know the mechanism of LDA. So how LDA going to abstract the proton? Okay, so what happened, LDA is a strong base. So what the structure of LDA, LDA structure is like this. This is non-nucleophilic base. So what happened, there are two types of acidic proton here, this proton is here and this proton is here. Okay, this is active methylene group. So what happened, we are using two equivalent of LDA. So what happened, this one from one active position one proton is released and from one position one proton is released. Okay, so you will get this type of product. Okay, OME, there will be negative charge and there will be negative charge. This bond migrate over here and it will form to enolate. Simultaneously this also migrate, you will get enolate. So this is the enolate what I have written over here. Okay, so two enolate will be formed. After formation of enolate, how it is formed, we are going to react with two equivalent of LDA. If one of the equivalent, one equivalent if you use, that going to attack on this position. Okay, this is a highly acidic proton. Okay, so two equivalent of LDA going to attack on this, so you will get enolate. After formation of enolate, what happen, one of the bond migrate to original position, this double bond get migrated and this double bond going to attack on this position. Sorry for that, this double bond going to migrate on this position, this double bond get migrated and your bromine will be kicked out. So what happen, so you will, you have to arrange this structure in a such a way it is match with the options. Okay, so if you see the, you have to make this structure in form of benzene type. Okay, benzene type, not exactly benzene, benzene looking type of structure. Okay, so you will get this type of species. Okay, this is your A. Okay, so your carbon carbon bond formation will be like this. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so 7 carbons are there and this is a 4 and 5. So this is your that group which is coming from allylic bromide. Okay, so after reducing this species, what happened, I told that lithium aluminum hydride is very strong reducing agent. So what happened, it will reduce that ketone. After getting this migration, this will get converted to ketone. Okay, and this ester also going to reduce. So just by knowing the mechanism, you eliminate two option, and just knowing the mechanism of LDA, you will get this product. Okay, so correct answer is A, you will not get this product. Okay, so there is, so this is not a correct product. Correct answer is A. Okay, correct answer is A, and A will be the, this answer correct, A will be this product. Okay, and B will be this product. Okay, so this is how you can solve. If you don't know the exact mechanism of particular reaction, just by knowing the if you do not know the LDA reaction, what kind of proton is, just by knowing the lithium aluminum hydride role, okay, this is a not a rare reagent, it generally very oftenly used in lab, so it is a very well known reagent. So you should know the famous reagent reducing and oxidizing property. So just by knowing the reducing property of lithium aluminum hydride, you will eliminate B and D. Now those who knowing the LDA, they can further go. So this is how elimination method can work. So it can reduce your stress during the exam. So this is a 4 marker, this is also 4 marker, just by knowing the role of one reagent. Okay, one reagent, you can eliminate these two option. Okay, now let's see some more example. Yeah, this is based on your LDA. This is also question based on your LDA. Okay, now this is a little but very near to reagent, but this is, we have it, they added ozonolysis. Okay, so this is also 4 marker from December 2011. So this was asked in, they are treated with this amine first and then followed by LDA, then methyl iodide, then it is done the ozonolysis. Okay, so you have to check the which will be the product. Now if you see this oxygen and this two hydrogen, okay, that will lead to removal of water. So this is I think I cover in my LDA video, that is hydrogen type of compound, your carbon nitrogen bond get form. So C and D directly eliminate. Okay, C and D directly eliminate. C and D will be not given here. Okay, so just by knowing this only, in presence of, if ketone react with this type of species, your nitrogen NH2 bond is there, elimination will be taken place. You directly eliminate C and D option, means your 50% work is done. We have to check that. So you should know that A and O option are nearly correct. Okay, nearly correct. There is a stereochemistry involved, and B also nearly. So there is a stereochemistry will be taking place. Now let's see the mechanism. So the A and B product of the A option and B option nearly same, just there is a stereochemistry is involved. Okay, let's see the mechanism. So first step, what happened, I'm already told that this is your A product. This is not A product, this is your A product. Okay, how this form minus water will leave this H2O and this. So this will lead to a hydrogen type of structure. This is similar to a hydrogen. I hope you know that what is a hydrogen. So you will get hydrogen. So LDA going to abstract proton from this. Okay, so you will get negative charge. After getting negative charge, this negative charge going to attack on this species. Now stereochemistry come in picture. So this OME group is the above the plane, that's why your CH3 going to attack on below the plane. Okay, below the plane going to attack. So only one option that contain this option. Okay, just by solving only one option, just by solving A up to, you can correct this. Okay, after what happen, this ozonolysis will actually break this double bond. What is ozonolysis? Adding oxygen. So this bond grab bait, you will get ketone. Okay, so that will be the your product, means just by knowing the first two reaction only, removal of water and LDA reaction with LDA. Okay, now with stereochemistry, why it is attacking below the plane? Because your this OOME group is above the plane. Okay, so you know that generally reagent generally prefer to attack on your Stirless sterically hindrance site. That's why your A option A and option B, both product are similar, but their methyl group stereochemistry change. See here, this is below the plane and this is above the plane. So this above the plane will be not very much stable. So below then above the plane will be the stable. Okay, just you don't know the ozonolysis mechanism, don't worry, just by saying this two also you can solve this question. Okay, so this is about this this is also 4 marker from December 2011. Now let's see some more example for this. So this is asked on your Gilman reagent, that is organo copper reagent. This was asked in June 2011. Okay, so they asked for Gilman reagent. This is ether, so ether is a solvent, okay, not any other species. So what happened, Gilman reagent, let's see the mechanism. So you can see from the mechanism, there is a ring cyclization, means ring formation. What do you mean by ring formation? That is cyclization going to take place, cyclization going to take place. Okay, now let's see the what type of condition. This is 6, this is 7, this is 6, this is 7 member ring, this is 6, this is 7, this is 6, and this is 5. Okay, let assume that you don't know mechanism of this Gilman reagent, how cyclization is going to take place, but for your convenience I written there 6 member ring, 7 member ring, 6 member ring, 7 member ring, 6 member, 7, and you know that generally 5 or 6 member ring is formed. Generally your compound is a 5 or 6 member ring is a more stable compared to 4 member or 7 member ring. Just by applying only this logic also you can get this answer correct. Okay, let's see, you don't know mechanism, you are assuming that this is a correct answer. Okay, and this is a correct answer. Okay, let's see how it again. So what happened, Gilman reagent actually go 1,4 addition. So what happened, one ME group going to attack on this position, one double bond going to migrate on this position, enolate will be formed. After formation of enolate, what happened, this is a formation of enolate. Okay, with 1,4 addition, so methyl group going to this place. Okay, methyl is from Gilman reagent, methyl going to attack from the below the plane, because this CH3, this carbon is above the plane. Okay, stereochemistry is involved in this. So what happened, after formation of enolate, this negative charge going to come back in original position, and this double bond lead to cyclization. Why cyclization? Because there is a iodine is present, so iodine will be acting as a leaving group which lead to cyclization. And why this form 6 and 5 member, there are other also. Okay, so no oxygen, so this A and B is not correct answer. Okay, and C, so only one correct answer will be there. Okay, this will be the D. If you don't know the mechanism, just by knowing the stability of particular ring you can answer this question. Okay, now let's see the one more question. ओके सो दिस इज अबाउट द यू हैव टू चेक दिस इज जून 2014 क्वेश्चन फॉर 4 मार्क्स यू हैव टू चूज द विच विल बी द करेक्ट करेक्ट रिएजेंट टू ट्रांसफॉर्म दिस दिस कंपाउंड विद हैविंग आयोडीन ग्रुप ओके लेट्स सी द सोल्यूशन फॉर दिस सो वॉट इज अ फर्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज अ ब्यूटाइल लिथियम मीन्स ब्यूटाइल लिथियम इज ऑर्गेनोलिथियम रिएजेंट सो वॉट इज ऑर्गेनोलिथियम रिएजेंट जनरली डू इट विल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट द प्रोटोन सो वॉट हैपन दिस एब्स्ट्रैक्ट द प्रोटोन सो यू विल गेट नेगेटिव चार्ज फॉर काउंटर आयन आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग देयर लिथियम आफ्टर दैट वॉट हैपन यू आर गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विद दिस कंपाउंड दैट इज CH2 CH2 I ओके CH2 CH2 I एंड दिस नेगेटिव चार्ज गोइंग टू अटैक ऑन दिस आयोडीन एंड यू विल गेट दिस सो इन रिएक्शन दे हैव सीन दैट दिट इज अ आयोडीन इज कार्बन आयोडीन बॉन्ड सो जनरली दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन फेवर्ड विद दिस ओनली ओके दिस इज अ वेरी स्ट्रांग बेस दैट्स वाई दिस विल बी फॉर्म बट दिस विल लीड टू डीप्रोटोनेशन बट देर इज अ नो आयोडीन डायरेक्टली इन्वॉल्व ओके सो करेक्ट ऑप्शन विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर डी सो दिस इज अ मैकेनिज्म यू कैन प्रैक्टिस दिस मैकेनिज्म दिस इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट सो दैट दिस क्वेश्चन आई एम नॉट कवर्ड इन LDA और ऑर्गेनोलिथियम रिएजेंट सो यू कैन चेक दिस एग्जाम्पल ओवर दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन आस्ट इन दिस क्वेश्चन आस्ट इन जून 2014 फॉर 4 मार्क्स सो दिस दे आर सो विच रिएजेंट कैन डू दिस जनरेशन ओके सो करेक्ट आंसर इज दिस दैट इज सेकेंडरी ब्यूटाइल लिथियम ओके सो दिस इज अबाउट द सम वी हैव टॉक अबाउट सम 4 to 5 क्वेश्चन सम योर प्रीवियस ईयर फ्रॉम रिएजेंट केमिस्ट्री आई विल मेक मोर वीडियो थेरोटिकल वीडियो ऑन रिएजेंट एज वेल एज आई विल मेक सेपरेट वीडियो ऑन प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर रिएजेंट केमिस्ट्री सो टिल एग्जाम विल बी कम वी विल थरो विद योर रिएजेंट केमिस्ट्री ओके सो इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज लाइक इट शेयर इट एंड ऑल्सो फॉलो मी इन एन अकेडमी एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल ओके थैंक यू